Welcome back to the JV Sports Show. I'm sure you recognize that tune right there, Vince. Jonathan Cain and Journey.
It's a Journey kind of day today. I love this band. So, yeah, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. So on the line with us is... Who's on the line with us?
We've got the head coach of the Benedictine University women's basketball team joining us this morning. Coach, are you there?
Yes, I am. Thank you.
Good morning. How are you, sir?
I'm doing great. I'm
Coach
doing great.
Brian Hutchins here with us from the Benedictine University Red Hawks. You guys have been rolling lately, Coach. Talk about the success of your basketball team right now.
Yeah, first I want to thank you guys for having me on. I think what you guys are doing, trying to promote NAIA and some high school stuff, has been fantastic. So I hope everything keeps rolling along.
We're trying. Thanks, Coach.
We appreciate that, Coach, so much. And you guys are doing great as well. I mean, you upset a huge team the other night in Montana Western. Is that correct?
Yeah, we did. Montana Western is defending national champions, and they're number 24 in NAIA Division I. And I've been fortunate enough. I think we've got a lot of support from our administration, from our athletic director. And ultimately, I think it just comes down to we've got some really good players here, just really, really ferocious competitors. And we were able to just execute a game plan and really just, I think, out-physical them, which rarely happens for them at their level.
Coach, you got a lot of local girls on your roster?
We actually have a mixture. We got a mixture of some local girls and a mixture of some out-of-state girls. So what we try to do is we always try to secure our backyard and make sure we're trying to get the best players possible here. And the one thing, too, just about Arizona girls basketball, it's just getting better and better. So there's lots of other schools trying to do the same thing we are. Fortunate enough just to be able to get some out-of-state players along with some local players that have really helped us. One local player that's really doing a great job for us is Leah Goodman. She's a little guard. She's one of our better shooters, just one of our better leaders, just one of those great, ferocious competitors that I talked about on our team.
Coach, postseason. So we're, you know, obviously you, every team wants to get to the postseason, but do you feel like you have the formula to get yourselves there this year?
Yeah, I think we do. I think getting the postseason winning is just so hard. It requires a lot of luck. It requires good players, a good strategy. I think as far as having the style to get to the postseason, I definitely feel confident that team can do this. We talk about doing a couple things every game. One of them is just having great attitude and effort, which this team has done every single game. I know when we show up, I'm not worried. Are we going to play hard? I always know that this team is going to battle to the end. So I love that about this group. Then we just talk about other couple things, just knowing our scout report. We're getting better on that. And then we just talk about like moving the ball and just being sharp on offense. So I think once we can kind of clean up some of the things we do offensively, I think the sky's the limit for this group. Yeah, I can definitely see us playing on the postseason.
Coach, after your last game against Montana State University Northern, now we're up against the Christmas break, and then you guys square off against Embry-Riddle University on January the 4th. Talk a little bit about what you guys are going to do over the next couple of weeks during the break as far as practices. Are the girls there every day, or how does that all work here? I know basketball never stops. My wife actually has a T-shirt that says the exact same thing. Basketball never stops, and truly never stops. So what are you guys doing here during this Christmas break, getting ready for that next game against Embry-Riddle?
Yeah, no, that shirt is true. Basketball never stops. I don't know if I've had a true winter vacation in all my years of coaching. But what we're going to do is I'm fortunate enough. I've got a really great family here. I've got two young girls, and they're listening now. They would really I don't know if I'd be the world's best dad if I didn't mention them. So Simone and Talia are my two daughters, and I like to spend a lot of time with them. So
awesome.
Coaches need some family time. I think the players need some family time. So we're actually off for about 7 days here. I think they need to go back, get recharged, get away from basketball. When we come back after that week, after that little bit of time off, we'll get back in the gym, work on those things that we had talked about, watch some film, have some team meetings, and really just try to continue to be a more cohesive group.
Coach, we appreciate you coming on with us, and we know obviously you being a local guy, you're hitting, you know, the ground running locally, trying to get to build that roster as much as possible with you know, as much local talent as you can. Even though you said you're pretty well balanced, you've got, you know, you're plugging kids in from whatever areas you can that just happen to meet the needs of your program. But a big factor in the fact that you grew up here in the Phoenix area in the East Valley where Benedictine University is located.
Yeah, one of the advantages I have, I was actually the girls basketball coach at Campbell Verde High School for 6 years. So I started that program. I coached locally in the Valley at a number of schools. I coached at Apache Junction, at Queen Creek, or Arcadia. So I had known the landscape for a little bit. So that was one thing when I was fortunate we were able to hit the ground running. And the other thing, too, with local kids is we've got a really good JUCO league. It's one of the best ones in the country. It's the Division I and the Division II level. So we're able to, if we can get a couple of those kids every year, then most of the time we end up having a pretty good roster.
Well, Coach, congratulations again on a very successful season. We look forward to following you throughout the rest of this campaign and probably into the playoffs because you guys are doing pretty good this year. So thanks for taking the time to join us this morning. We appreciate it, and we'll catch up with you again real soon.
All right, sounds good, and thank you guys, and you guys keep doing what you're doing, and Vince, I'm going to tell your dad happy birthday also.
Oh, how nice. Thanks, Coach. Thank you very much. There you go. All right. Okay, joining us on the line.
Vince, our lines are full for the first time.
This is the first time ever. And I don't think it's because of us. Gina? Good
morning.
Hey.
Good.